Hi, this is Chrisferb, and I'm going to demonstrate how to perform a confidence interval calculation using a desktop version of Excel and Office 365. For Mac users, I do not have a Mac to demonstrate this on, but if you have access to Office 365, I recommend using that because it will work with Macs online theoretically. Okay, we'll get started. Now we have the data listed here. It says we're going to do our example for a 95% confidence interval for a sample mean of 15, standard deviation of 2, and a sample size of 30. I am trying to keep this as generic as possible, so the standard deviation does not say what type of standard deviation, whether it's a sample or it is a population. The other thing is our sample size, I picked 30. The assumption would be the data is normalized, although I'm going to show you how you would apply this to the t-distribution. And then we'll take a look at Office 365. Okay, so to start, we go to the formula tab. I already have it open. Let's say you're on the home tab. So you're on the home tab, you go to the formula tab, and then you click on more functions. And then you click on statistical, and this opens up the confidence.norm and confidence.t. So the norm is the normal distribution or Z distribution that we would normally think of, and then the t is for the t distribution. So I'm going to show you how this works primarily on the normal distribution, but I'll open up the t distribution at the end as well. Okay, I'm gonna put this side by side. So we have a couple things to consider here. The way that this interface is set up, it's set up with alpha. So alpha, if we remember in some of my prior videos, alpha is the part in the tail. So when we think about the confidence interval, we're looking for 95% that is around the mean or mu typically. So if we're thinking about the 95% that's around the most common parts of the distribution, the most frequent, where the data lies most frequently, if in a curve, the bell curve, normal distribution curve, we think of alpha being the far reaches of that in the tail portion. So when we do testing and we have, say, a cutoff of where we reject or do not reject and different things like that, it's the that cutoff is where alpha is in the tail, and then on the other side is where the beta is. So when it says 95% confidence interval, that's written in beta type of numbers. It's essentially saying 0.95 confidence interval. And so to convert that over to put it in here, what we're going to do is put in 0.05, because the alpha and the beta needs to equal 1. And so so we always have to convert that. For standard deviation, whether we're doing the t-distribution or the normal distribution confidence norm, we're just going to put in the standard deviation that we're given here, and this is 2. And then for size, this is essentially our n number, which is the sample size. So we do 30. And then if you notice, I did not use the sample mean. So this formula or interface for Excel does not use the sample mean. So what we actually get is we actually get the margin of error in this problem, but we don't get the true confidence interval. What we do is we get the margin that it can be plus or minus, and we don't get the whole thing. And that's because, in my opinion, when they created Excel, they created it kind of in a broad sweep of, they made all these functions, but a lot of them don't have the most user-friendliness. And so take, for instance, as confidence norm, it could say margin of error would be a more appropriate title for this. So I'm going to hit OK. And this is what it produces. So this is actually our margin of error to properly, if we were to list out what the actual confidence interval, it would be something like this. It would be our sample mean, which would be 15, and then it would be plus and minus. I know there's a symbol for this, but I don't have it real quick. So it'd be 15 plus or minus the answer, which is 0.7156, something like that. So 15 plus or minus 0.7156, and that would be the answer. So this just gets us the margin of error. Well, let's just take a look real quick at the same thing, but with a T distribution, and then we'll look at the Office 365. So the confidence T, so this is for our T distribution questions, when we don't have a population standard deviation, or we don't know much about the sample, if it's from, our sample is from a normalized sample, and we have a really small, and or we have a really small sample type of scenario. So let's take a look at this. So it says alpha, so that's the same. We're always going to, let's say we had another example where it was 98% confidence interval, we would put in 0.02 right here. So the alpha and the beta always has to equal 1. And then the standard deviation, we put in the sample standard deviation in this case with the T distribution, and then the size, which is N. So it's the same type of scenario the way we set it up. So they're both used the same type of way. And this will give you your margin of error, just the margin of error on one side. Theoretically, you go and you plus and minus that from the mean, and we'll actually have the confidence interval. Okay, I want to get out of here. Hit escape to get out. Okay, let's take a look at Office 365. So I'm in Office 365. I'm in a school account. And what we're going to do is go to formulas. Oh, it's not that one. It's insert. So this is the weirdest thing, in my opinion, about Office 365, is that if you go to formulas, it's not readily obvious. But if you go to insert and then function, it'll come up with this little menu. Maybe inside of the formulas, what was there would lead us to the same thing, but it's not very user-friendly in that regard. So you go to insert, function, and then we go here. And we're going to pick statistical. So it gets us to the same place. That's not a problem. We're going to go down to... here we go, confidence norm and confidence T, so same scenario. And in this case, I'm just going to do the norm. Now, this shows the inputs. Now, this is the other thing about Office 365. It doesn't give us what they used to call WYSIWYG wizard type of things. So it doesn't give us a nice interface to do the input. We have to, it's fine, but we just have to do this. So we put this in, and we have to type in the data. So in this case, type in the data, comma type of deal. So for alpha, remember, let's just say we're still doing the 95%. So 95% confidence interval would be 0.05, comma, standard deviation. I don't remember what I had listed, but I'm going to put in 2. And then comma, size, we're going to put in 30. And then I do close parentheses. If you don't do close parentheses, it won't work. So you always have to remember your commas. And then we get our answer right here. So in this case, we can do this type of calculation, confidence intervals, both in Office 365 in the desktop version. Now, the correct answer, if we're trying to actually find the confidence interval, is, remember, it would be whatever the mean is, which is like 15, and then it would be the plus or minus, and let's see. The plus and minus. Oh. And then it would be our answer, which is something like 0.7156. It does look prettier when you put in the symbol for this, but I won't waste your time looking. So that would actually be the confidence interval. Now, one other thing, this notation for the answer is perfectly fine. It's the not solved kind of format, but it's fine because you can take this and you can actually do the math plus and minus, and you actually have the low and the high. So that's it. So thank you.